Well, what is Bitcoin in one word? I mean, is it fintech?
Store of value? It's very hard to say, and one word would be almost impossible. It's an interesting technology behind it, i.e. blockchain, but ultimately I think it's a way for people to avoid the long arm of government in currency transactions.
Yeah, I think that's the main problem with it. If you're trying to avoid the government, ultimately it's under threat from huge regulatory risk because there's concerns around money laundering and everything else. So I think there's a big risk from governments banning these currencies eventually.
And Ed, I think our concern this morning was the largest digital coin fell 12% today. And I was like, okay, a 12% move for Bitcoin, you know, do we get Ed on to talk about it or not? Is it a big deal?
Yes, I think it is a big deal for exactly that reason, that the regulatory risk has really come to the fore with South Korea. And the question investors have right now is, will they or won't they? There's been all of these mixed signals coming out of the South Korean government on whether they would ban trading.
Right.
I mean, actually ban trading in these currencies, which is above and beyond what China's done with ICOs.
So why, I mean, South Korea is concerned because people are actually getting loans, right, to buy some of the cryptocurrencies.
Yeah, South Korea thinks it's out of control. I mean, people are taking mortgages out to buy Bitcoin. You can see just in the demand, I mean, Bitcoin trades in South Korean exchanges at up to 40% premiums. Then on other exchanges, there's so much demand for it. So just culturally, South Koreans have, let's say, an affinity for Bitcoin and digital currencies, and the government is freaking out.
So in China, how much can they crack down? How much is their appetite to actually crack down even further than what they've done so far?
China's very interesting because it's followed this cycle before with new innovations when it comes to technology. It kind of lets it run free for a while, then it cracks down, and then winners will shake out and the state will have a lot of control. So right now in the cycle in China, we're in kind of a crackdown, but I think investors anticipate that at some point there will be a regime that emerges that is stable.